Nepal is a beautiful country blessed with natural and cultural heritage, renowned all over the world as the birthplace of Gautam Buddha. Buddha's principle and teaching is inspiration for humankind. Besides Nepal, Buddhist practitioners and scholars all over the world have made priceless contribution to spread the message of humankind, and one of them is Lopon Chechu Rinpoche.
Kundon jango zange dado jen rado zemak doje jivu cha dewa joye pande jivu.
His eminence Lopon Chechu Rinpoche was born in 1918 AD in Norbughang, Punakha district of Bhutan, to father Sonam Gelsen and mother Trinle Dolma as Nawang Damchui Gelsen. At the tender age of 4, he lost his father. Following that, he started his journey of religious study at the age of 7 from Punakha Jong. He took the vow of Upasaka from His Holiness Sabdrung Jigme Dorji and took the vow of Novice Monk from His Holiness Si Shi Namgyel, the 58th Supreme Religious Leader of Bhutan. In the Jong, he learned all the rituals of Drukpa Kagyu tradition, the classical prayer for worshipping of mandala, cultural dance and reading technique. Lopon Chechu with mother Trinle Dolma and family came to Nepal from Bhutan via Tibetan border. They stayed at Drakmar Chonglung Cave nearby great practitioner Yogendra Milarepa Center, Nepal-Tibet border at Dolakha district and met His Holiness Drukpa Rinpoche. He got the initiation, oral transmission and explanation about the preliminary practice of Mahamudra and Mahayan traditional fast practice from Drukpa Rinpoche. He spent 1 year for fast practice by having only liquid. In 1935, at the age of 18, Drukpa Rinpoche sent him to Bhutan at Tharpaling Monastery. Chechu Rinpoche studied common knowledge and various spiritual textbooks for 7 years under the guidance of His Eminence Gese Pema Chiring and gained unusual wisdom at young age. During the same time in 1943, Chechu Rinpoche returned from Bhutan to Nepal. After learning different religious books including Six Yogas of Naropa from Drukpa Rinpoche, Chechu Rinpoche went Yogendra Milarepa Center for Meditation in Drakar Taso. Then Puron Phuk of Gorakha, then Lapchi Chubar of Dolakha and Pema Shel of Sindhu Palchuk. Similarly, Chechu Rinpoche learned from Khensi Rapsal Dawa, 16th Karmapa Rikpai Dorji, Chupsang Rinpoche, Dudom Rinpoche, Sakya Gongma and Thobge Thrichen Rinpoche as well. In 1944, Drukpa Rinpoche appointed Kuso Tenjing to look after the Mu Monastery and Rachen Noneri situated at Chum Valley of Gorakha District, and he handed over the responsibility of Bagham Monastery of Sindhu Palchuk and Bigu Noneri of Dolakha District to Lopon Chechu Rinpoche. After the demise of Kuso Tenjing, he looked after Mu Monastery. Rachen Noneri, Bagham Monastery, Bigu Noneri along with other monasteries. He also had to look after the Kidron Thukje Choiling Noneri group, which was established by Drukpa Rinpoche at Tibet and came to Nepal in 1959 in exile. Drukpa Rinpoche took his last breath in the meditation center situated at Puma at the base of Amabhamari Himalaya of Nepal-Tibet border of Dolakha district. Lopon Chechu Rinpoche invited Thupsang Rinpoche from Tibet and performed the last ritual prayers of Drukpa Rinpoche at Bigu Noneri of Dolakha district. The absence of his teacher was badly felt by Chechu Rinpoche, so you started searching for the incarnation of teacher Drukpa Rinpoche in various remote parts of Nepal, Tibet and Bhutan. Finally, with the help of 16th Karmapa of Thurfu Monastery, Tibet and Thupsang Rinpoche from Shelkar Dong came to identify the reincarnation. The religious process of enthronement of incarnation His Eminence Nawang Khenrab Dorji was done at Thukje Choiling Nonnery, established by Drukpa Rinpoche in 1952 AD. In 1973, His Majesty King Birendra Bir Bikram Sahadev decorated Chichu Rinpoche with Gorakha Dakshin Bahu, recognizing his effort to preserve and promote Buddhist religion and culture all over Nepal and Northern Himalayan region in specific. In 1977, after the completion of Namgyel Choiling Monastery at Rasbir of Soilung Doramba village panchayat of Ramechhap district, he performed the Rabne process of the monastery. In 1975, Lopon Chechu Rinpoche proposed His Majesty King and His Majesty Government to form Remote Area Development Committee for the conservation of ancient Buddhist religion, social tradition and culture of Northern Himalayan region. Then after, Remote Area Development Committee was formed. In 1986, Lama priests from all over the world united to conserve, promote and develop the Buddhist religion and culture and formed Buddhist organization called All Nepal Himalayan Buddhist Association. Similarly, he established Buddha Academy at Jorpati, Kathmandu for the children of Buddhist priests and general people who wants to receive the Buddhist education, as there was not any curriculum for Buddhist education in the education system of Nepal. Therefore, schools started to provide education not only about religion but also in Nepali, English and Sambhuta Lipi, which is continuing till date. It was difficult to make plan and implement them for Remote Area Development Committee targeting only Buddhist monastery. Therefore, on initiation of Chechu Rinpoche, His Majesty Government formed Monastery Development Committee for the conservation and renovation of Buddhist monastery. Then after, he took the responsibility of Nepal Dharmodaya Sabha and Nepal Regional Center. Before that, only Hinayana monk can chair the Dharmodaya Sabha. Chechu Rinpoche broke the tradition from that day. The new tradition was formed to choose the chairperson on the acceptance of Hinayana, Mahayana and Vajrayana of Buddhist religion. On the invitation of his main follower Lama Oli Nedel and Hana, Chechu Rinpoche for the first time made a religious visit to Europe, Russia and Mongolia. Similarly, he started to address his follower visiting America, Singapore, Hong Kong and Taiwan. He made various Buddhist stupas in countries where he had been. In 1994, Khenpo Kalsang, the main follower of Chechu Rinpoche, suggested him to build the head monastery in Kathmandu to look after all those monasteries that was built by Drukpa Rinpoche in Nepal. Then after, Chechu Rinpoche has made Sangye Choiling Monastery, which was at Giddakuti Hill of Kimdol, Swayambhu, Kathmandu. In 1997, November 21st, the Sangye Choiling Monastery was completed. And the late King Birendra Bir Bikram Sahadev present for inaugural ceremony of the monastery. Local people from Kirong, Hyalmo Society, Chumpa and many foreigners were present to welcome His Excellency. The environment was very jolly and happy with the news of the king's arrival for the inauguration of monastery. Chechu Rinpoche inaugurated monastery with prayer and offering statue, religious book and stupa, the sign of body, speech and mind. Wishes for good health and long life of the king. The ceremony was filled with traditional ritual dance and songs of Hyolmo, Kirong and Tum Valley, Tum region. After the program in the same year, 21 monks were brought from the central monastery of Bhutan to Nepal on the request of Chechu Rinpoche. The following year, every Phagun Krishna Dasami, monks continued to come to Nepal to perform traditional dance and the tradition still continues. On the auspicious day of Buddha's descent from the heaven, Lopon Chechu Rinpoche started to give the religious speech to his followers living all over the world. In 1999, he went to Nizargang of Punakha, Bhutan to participate in the inauguration program of stupa. Similarly, Lopon Chechu Rinpoche represented Nepal in Grand Seminar of Mahabodhi Society, Asian Buddhist Association and Tibetan All Buddhist Association. Lopon Chechu Rinpoche spent his entire life for the betterment of living beings and the religion. However, he suffered from the heart disease and we could not save his life in spite of a protective prayer, ritual for the sake of long life and medical treatment. In 10th June 2003, he took his last breath at 7:14 a.m. at the Bumrungrad International Hospital of Bangkok, Thailand. The dead body of Chechu Rinpoche was brought to Nepal in 12th June 2003 from Bangkok. Monks and nuns of different monasteries, members of different organizations, local people, devotees were present at Tribhuvan International Airport. Then, the dead body was taken to the Sangye Choiling Monastery at Swayambhu Kimdol. Then after, His Eminence Tenga Rinpoche, along with monk priests, incarnations, abodes and scholars, perform the ritual of offering holy waters. On the 49th day, Singdrak Rinpoche, Sangsang Rinpoche and Kunjik Samar Rinpoche perform the death ritual. Then, Queen of Bhutan Ashi Chiring Palmo also arrived in Nepal to participate in the death ritual of Lopon Chechu Rinpoche. As per the wish of Bhutan's royal mother Thukje Jangmo and King, the body of Sechu Rinpoche was taken to Bhutan in 30th July 2003. Royal Mother Thukje Jangmo, Secretary of the Palace Dorji Gyalsen, Dorji Lopon Yonten Gyalsen, Drapi Lopon Kunli Gyalsen, Yangpi Lopon Chime, Senne Lopon Tadrin Chewang, Reincarnation of Lama Sonam Jangbo, Lamneten of Paro Monastery Dorji Richen, Government Officials, Security personnel welcome the Sechu Rinpoche according to Bhutani tradition. On the way from Paro Airport to capital Thimphu, students from different schools and local people welcome the Rinpoche and pay tribute to him. Royal family of Bhutan, Lama monks, high-level officials and representatives from 20 districts along with general people gave him a grand welcome at Dechen Fodrang Monastery. The prince Jigme Gesar Wangchuk showed his faith towards Sechu Rinpoche by giving his shoulder. On the presence of the royal family member, His Eminence Dorji Lopon Kunli of Government Monastery offered holy water to the dead body. From the second day, on the guidance of His Holiness 70th Kyabje Trulku Jigme Choidrak, monks of government monasteries and Dechen Fodrang Monastery performed the death rituals for 9 days. With the permission of Nawang Khinrab Dorji, Khenpo Kalsang along with the monks from Sangye Choiling Monastery Kimdol Swembu requested the highest in hierarchy religious leader J. Khenpo from Bhutan in first priority, 14th Dalai Lama in second priority and Chobge Thechen Rinpoche in third priority to identify the incarnation of Lopon Chechu Rinpoche. Fortunately, the religious guru from Bhutan accepted the request. In 8th August 2003, as per plan to bring back the dead body of Sechu Rinpoche to Nepal, royal family members, representatives from government monasteries, monk organization, meditation center, education minister Sangye Nudup, health minister Jigme Sangye Commander-in-Chief Kado, and bureaucrats, security personnel, and hundreds of his followers paid the last tribute to him from Thimphu Dechen Phodrang to Paro Airport. Though it was decided that the non-living body of Chetu Rinpoche would be burnt in funeral pyres, a strange thing was noticed after bringing the non-living body of Chetu Rinpoche to Nepal. There used to be pleasant smell and rainbow light seen in the room of monastery where the body was kept. So, the non-living body was kept in the monastery itself, building 11 feet long gold-plated copper stupa on the uppermost room of monastery, which still stands today. After the demise of Chetu Rinpoche, the responsibility of monastery has been taken by his main follower Khenpo Kalchang, with the support of Lama Nono, Lama Tinder, Lama Wangda, Lopon Jopa, Lopon Dondrup, Lopon Sonam, Lopon Tupki, Lopon Sherab, Lopon Lungri, and Lopon Tenjing till date. In 1998, with the help of Spain government, Lopon Chetu started to construct the 108-feet Enlightenment Stupa in Spain. City Mayor Don Enrique provided required land at Benalmadena of Spain. Chetu Rinpoche passed away before the completion of stupa. The remaining work was completed by Khenpo Kalchang. In 2003, Lama Nono along with 21 monks of Sangye Choiling Monastery went to Spain for the inauguration. Chamar Rinpoche, Lama Oli Nedal, Education Minister of Bhutan, Sangye Nudup, Royal Family Member Sonam were also present at the function. The program was closed with the cultural monk dance. Initiation of Khenpo Kalchang, Lama monks and officials requested famous monks from all over the world to search for the reincarnation of Rinpoche. Prayers were made regularly for the reincarnation of Rinpoche. Likewise, Bauddha Shrine of India, Kusinagar, Saranath and Bodh Gaya, Bauddha Shrine of Nepal, Lumbini, Swayambhunath, Bauddhanath, and Namo Buddha light a butter lamp and performed Bhadracharya Pranidhan worships. Followed by various prayers, pujas until 2 years, in the workplace of His Holiness Sabdrung Nawang Namgyel in the capital of Bhutan, Thimphu, the incarnation was burned to Father Tenjing Namgyel and Mother Karma in a place called Bavisa. His birth name was Sonam Richen, given by Jigme Choidrak religious guru. Similarly, Namkhai Ningpo Rinpoche named him Tashi Oisar, so his parents started calling him, combining both names, Sonam Tashi. From the childhood, he was attracted to monks, religion, religious instruments. There were times when he would threaten his parents saying he would go to Nepal to be a monk. He would say stories about his previous life events with his friends out of nowhere. So he was different than other normal child. In 4th August 2008, child Sonam Tashi with his mother came Nepal for a religious visit. He stayed at a guest house near Bauddha Stupa and visited the religious places around the Kathmandu. While visiting Donga Choiling Monastery at Swayambhu Stupa, the child Sonam Tashi, looking at the picture of Drukpa Rinpoche, told Lama Tender that he is his teacher sitting at the place of Lopon Cheju. He shared some interesting fact about previous life. This all happened all of a sudden, so there was not a chance of taking pictures and recording his words. After visiting the Swayambhu Stupa, he came to visit Sangye Choiling Monastery at Kimdol. There, looking at the picture of Bagha Monastery of Sindhu Palchok district, he told that he had to go there repeatedly. He asked Lopon Sherab to bring his religious dress to participate in the prayers. At that time, Saharsa Puja of Bhagavati Bijaya was being performed, and also told that the upper story of monastery has been changed. He bowed in front of the stupa where the dead body of Chechu Rinpoche was kept and offered a light, and when he tried to ascend to a religious throne, his mother told him not to do so. When he reached the room, he told that he will perform the puja and told others to do prayers. Then he started to play the instruments and to show the various amazing activities. He started to get information about Meme Dangchup Samten when he was taken to Chechu Rinpoche's house. He denied and told to go next day. From the next day, looking at the activities of child, like giving blessing to monk, ascending to throne, playing instrument, his mother became afraid and avoid to bring him in monastery. When the application was sent to J. Khempo Trulku Jigme Choidrak, he told to examine him secretly for 3 years. After 3 years, supreme religious leader told that child Sonam Tashi is the reincarnation of Chechu Rinpoche and ordered the committee to make his identity public. Druk Menjong Trulku Noijing Thokpa also concluded that Sonam Tashi is the reincarnation of Chechu Rinpoche. Thus, supreme leader decided for the enthronement of Sonam Tashi as the real incarnation of Chechu Rinpoche. In 12th July 2011, Khempo Kalchang, Daso Sangye Wanchuk, Lama Nono, Lama monks from 5 different monasteries of Nepal and relatives of Rinpoche from Nepal welcomed Sonam Tashi, his parents and family to Tashi Choijong Monastery at Thimphu. Sonam Tashi greeted Supreme Leader His Holiness Gyabje Rinpoche thrice and presented him an auspicious scarf as a symbol of faith.
Maya Namo Sangaya Malik Tola Nitam.
Then he laid ordination and named him as Jigme Choing Norbu, given by His Holiness Gyabje Rinpoche. Then he had his hair cut as per Buddhist tradition and offered Lama attire. His Eminence Lopon Chime Rinpoche changed the dress of the child. His Holiness Gyabje Rinpoche completed the process of changing name, ideology and identity and made a formal announcement that Sonam Tashi is the reincarnation of Chechu Rinpoche and gave auspicious scarf. The highest in hierarchy religious leader gave His Eminence Jigme Choing Norbu Buddha's statue, spiritual books and stupa, Vajra, Bhumandal as Buddha's resemblance, wishing for long life and religious works of Choing Norbu, and also composed a prayer to be read, which was provided to all the invitees for the long life of Jigme Choing Norbu. Taking the number 7 as auspicious sign of 7 Heriya Buddhas, tea program was organized in chairmanship of His Holiness Gyabje Rinpoche for His Eminence Jigme Choing Norbu, Khenpo Kalchang, Lama Nono, Dasho Sangye Wanchuk, Father Tenjing Namgyel and Mother Karma. His Holiness Gyabje Rinpoche gave advice and religious guidelines to Khenpo Kalsang, Lama Nono, Dasso Sangye Wanchuk, Mother and Father both. After worshipping the Buddhist protector Mahakal at Thimpu Tashi Choijung, he left from Thimpu Tashi Choijung Monastery to Dechen Fodrang Monastery. Daso Urgen, monks sponsor and all the followers welcomed Rinpoche to Dechen Phodrang Monastery. Rinpoche offered auspicious scarf and lit a lamp. In the leadership of Chairperson of Investigation Committee Bajracharya His Eminence Dorji Lopon Punle Rinpoche, Tago University of Buddhist Higher Study Dechen Phodrang Monastery, monks of Buddhist school started the prayers sitting at their respective positions. In this process of enthronement, Lopon Kunli offered 8 auspicious signs to Rinpoche. Lopon Kunli offered auspicious scarf and certified him for the reincarnation of Lopon Chechu Rinpoche. Representative from Sangye Choiling Monastery at Kimdol Swembu, Bagha Monastery from Sindhupalchok, Swembu Old Monastery, Bigu Monastery of Dolakha, Kerung Noneri, Sailung Monastery of Ramechhap District of Nepal presented Tripitak. After that, representative of Government Monastery of Punakha and Thimpu, Monk Organization, Meditation Center and relatives of Lopon Chechu Rinpoche from Nepal presented Tripitak with the scarf as auspicious sign. Representative of 4th King of Bhutan, Minister Chenkap, and Representative of 5th King, Secretary Paljor, Dasho Urgen and Ashi Budar, Royal Mother Thukje Jangmo presented Mandal Statue, Dharma Book and Stupa. Similarly, First Prime Minister of Bhutan, Jigme Waithrinle, presented scarf as auspicious sign. Dasho Urgen Chekyap, Dasho Topke, Ashi Deki, Secretary Dasho Sangye Khandro, offered auspicious scarf, while Head of Security Council, Bureau Business Owners and thousands of followers participated in the religious enthronement ceremony and offered auspicious scarf and showed their respect and faith. Representative of Chechu Rinpoche's monastery from Nepal and relatives of Chechu Rinpoche from Nepal offered scarf as an auspicious sign to the parents of Jigme Choeng Norbu Rinpoche. In 15th July 2011, Incarnation listened the oral transmission of Mahamudra preliminary practice from His Holiness Kyabje Tenjing Dondrup and Kyabje Rinpoche offered mandala, Buddha's statue, dharma book and stupa to the Incarnation for His long life and prosperity. In 8th August 2011, Jigme Choeng Norbu went to meet His Holiness Kunjig Samar Rinpoche. It is an auspicious date. The same day, Lord Buddha taught the first teaching on Four Noble Truths. Chechu Rinpoche was a good being respecting religious tolerance and has a huge contribution in Karma Kagyu community. Samar Rinpoche offered any sort of help if the Incarnation needs and also provided assurance that he would pray that this life becomes more fulfilling and full of good works than previous one. After about an hour of conversation, he returned. In 6th March 2012, His Eminence Jigme Choeng Norbu Rinpoche, along with his family, arrived Nepal for the enthronement. Representative from Sangye Choiling Monastery, All Nepal Himalayan Buddhist Association, Bauddha Academy School, along with other organization welcome Jigme Choeng Norbu Rinpoche at Tribhuvan International Airport and took him to Hyatt Hotel. In 8th March 2012, Tibetan Water Dragon Year, full moon day of Tibetan first month with the help of police personnel, volunteers from Hyolmo, Sherpa, Tamang and Gurung organization took out welcome rally in motorcycle from Hyatt Residency to Sangye Choiling Monastery. In the process, Hyolmo Society welcomed at Chabel, Himali Sherpa Society welcomed at Chuchepati Chabel, Gurung Society were placed at Maharajgan Sankha Park. Thading Tamang Society at Balaju in Banasthali. Nun of Kirong Thukje Choiling Monastery at Swayambhu Buddha Park. Druk Lundrup Dechen Choikhorling Monastery at Swayambhu Kimdol along with Pechen Monk Organization, All Nepal Himalayan Buddhist Association for the welcome program. Rinpoche received Jigme Choing Norbu Rinpoche and accompanied him to venue. Drukpa Rinpoche delivered a welcome speech.
Khenpo, Geshe, Tome, Tadun, Sobohage, Nidikage, Sangma Dela Chini Nama, Nekra Shi Dele Shu, Mangchero Nepali Somade, Zan Nepali Tola, Tungtung De Shu Na, Gama, Chuzo De, Tadene, Azu, Amro, Sichu Rinpoche, Tamchi Dede Rinpoche.
On the auspicious occasion of enthronement of Lopon Chechu Rinpoche, various respective personalities from Bhutan, Dorji Lopon Kunli, Thukje Jangmo, Ugen Dorji, Lonpo, Khenpo, Geshe, Lopon were present. Brief introduction of Lopon Chechu Rinpoche was given. The involvement of Chechu Rinpoche in politics was discussed as the main reason to establish the relationship between government and Buddhist religion. As a result, Remote Area Development Committee and Monastery Development Committee was formed, followed by the formation of various Buddhist organizations, schools and so on. In short, the political activities by Chechu Rinpoche had been for the well-being of Buddhist religion and world at large. Today, on the auspicious occasion of enthronement of Lopon Chechu Rinpoche, various respective Dorji Lopon Kunlek, Thukje Jangmo, Ugen Dorji, ministers, abbots, professors were present. I would like to throw light about previous life short in 10 minutes. Chechu Rinpoche was born in Bhutan at Norbu Ghang. He was a nephew of previous Drukpa Rinpoche. In 1918, Drukpa Rinpoche visited Nepal for renovation of Swayambhu Stupa on behalf of Bhutan's religious leader. He constructed few monasteries and nunneries at different places of Nepal after finishing the renovation. He stayed in Nepal for retreat and gave teachings to Nepali devotees. Chechu Rinpoche met Drukpa Rinpoche when he came with his mother and other relatives. From that day, he served for him and decided to stay in Nepal. He studied in Bhumthang Tharpaling Monastery. He completed 13 Buddhist philosophical textbooks from teacher Geshe Pema Chiring. In Nepal, he learned Mahamudra, 6 doctrines of Naropa, and all knowledge of Drukpa Kagyu tradition from previous Drukpa Rinpoche. He did meditation at the pilgrims of great practitioners Padma Sambhava and Milarepa. He learned about other Tibetan Buddhist traditions, listened oral transmission and took initiations from Khensegrapsal Dawa, 16th Karmapa Rikpai Dorji, Sakya Trijing, Duttom Rinpoche, Chujang Rinpoche, and so on. Many people thought that he played politics and made relations with politicians. The main reason for the involvement of Chechu Rinpoche in politics was to establish good relationship between Nepal government and Buddhist religion. As a result of his efforts, the Nepal government established Development Committee of Remote Area, Monastery Development Committee. He also formed All Nepal Himalayan Buddhist Association and Buddha Academy Boarding School. He believed in religious tolerance. These all are the cause of Chechu Rinpoche's good relationship with Nepal government. Whatever he did is for the benefit of Buddhism and humankind. Now, I would like to introduce reincarnation of Chechu Rinpoche. This incarnation was born in Bhutan. I sent letter to Sangye Chöling Monastery to search for the incarnation. Hence, identified by the religious leader J. Khenpo from Bhutan, I am glad and satisfied why many High Lamas take rebirth in the world. The main reason behind the rebirth of many High Lamas in this world is to complete beneficial work which was left behind in his previous life. I hope he will serve for precious dharma and benefit of all living beings as Chechu Rinpoche did. Let us pray for him. Thank you, Tashi Dile. Then after Drukpa Rinpoche handed over auspicious eight elements, namely mirror, medicinal concretion from the brains of elephant, cord, pine green grass, apple, conch shell, vermilion and white mustard seed to Jigme Choing Norbu as per Buddhist religion. It is believed that Lord Buddha had once been given those eight elements as significance of auspiciousness and power. In the same occasion, showing their respect to newly incarnated Guru, Sangye Chöling Monastery Kimdol Swayambhu offered Mandal Kusung Thukten. Uggen Dorji and Thukje Jangmo from Bhutan offered Mandal Kusung Thukten. Pasupati Samse Rana offered auspicious scarf. Kunga Rinpoche representing Drukchen Rinpoche, Lama Sherab Gelsen from Manang, Sangsang Rinpoche, Samar Rinpoche and various representatives from monasteries of Nepal offered Mandal Kusung Thukten. Thank you. The program was followed by songs and dances by the students of Buddha Academy, Jorpati, Kathmandu, reflecting Nepali culture and tradition. Songs and dances by Chumpa and Kirong community from Tum region, Gorakha, reflecting their culture. Similarly, the program was made more interesting by the song and dance performances of Bhutanese artist and Hyolmo music. Lambu Society of Sindhupaltok District performed Hyolmo music and dance. It is certain that birth is followed by death. Everyone dies one day or another day. So, in this mortal life, let's give up one's own selfish interest. Help people in need. May all of us have long life. May our life be meaningful. May our action, speech, and thought be positive. These are our dedicated prayers from the bottom of our heart. At the end, Venerable Drukpa Rinpoche, Nawang Khenrab Dorji, has given long life initiation to all gathered people. The program has been organized by Sangye Choiling Monastery, Tashi Dilek.
Oh, Lord.